Now, there's one thing we've learned from astronomy class. It is that space is spacious. So what does that mean, space is spacious? Well, if you were to take away everything we have, the people and the buildings and all the planets, what would we be left with? Nothing? Not really. Space is something, and it is as real as everything else. And the funny thing about space is that it can bend, it can twist, and it can ripple. So it's so real that empty space forms the shape of everything around us and the very fabric of the cosmos. We don't really think about space, but I bet that fish don't really think about water either. So we know atoms are made almost entirely of empty space. For example, if you were to take the Empire State Building and remove all the empty space between everything that makes up, all the elements that make up the Empire State Building, all the glass and the steel and everything, and condense it down into just what it is, without any of the space, you would be left with something the size of a grain of rice, except weighing hundreds of millions of pounds. So space, we don't give it a second thought. When in 1700s, Newton thought space was like a stage, and it was the structure of everything, and it was stagnant. It didn't move. Everything moved within it. Now, this model was very good for predicting how things we see work, how it explains our physics, like how a rocket takes off or how a windmill works. However, so this model worked very well for 200 years until Einstein looked at it again. Einstein, growing up in the late 1800s, was very interested in electricity and light, not just like streetlights or flashlights, but light itself. And it was the speed of light that allowed him to overturn Newton's theory of space. So we know now that light, the speed of light is always constant, no matter how fast anything else it was going. It was always 671 million miles per hour. No matter if it's on a car light, if it's on a car and the car is moving with the light, it doesn't go any faster. Now, we know that light is always at a constant speed, and no matter how fast anything else on it is going, it is always going to be that same speed, which is 671 million miles per hour. And no matter if it's on a car light and the car is going 20 miles an hour, it's not going to go any faster than 671 million miles an hour. Now, how could that be? How could light go the same speed no matter what's on it? Einstein figured out that speed is just a measure of space traveling over time. He proposed that space and time could work together, constantly adjusting by just the right amount, so that no matter how fast anything else was going, it would always be the same amount. And this was space-time. Time and space had to cease to be absolute and had to be relative. If I was in a car and I was going the speed of light, if you were outside the car, you would see it get very small, the car get very small and condense as we're going, and narrow as we're going faster. Now, inside the car, everything else would look the same. You know, space is normal inside the car. But if I were to look outside the car, I would see everything warping around. This is space bending around time so that it can still be at that constant speed. Time and space are not their own entities. They are relative and changing for each other. But we don't see this in normal life. Like when I'm just driving down the street, I don't see everything warping around me because we are not going quite fast enough for us to see this. So what does this have to do with space? Well, this has to do with gravity. How does gravity work over thousands of miles? What is this kind of force that pulls everything else around us? The secret of gravity lies in space-time. Space-time is like a fabric. It works, and it can stretch just like a fabric. It's space, we're like an empty table. Things would go straight, no gravity. Space is like a fabric, it can stretch and bend. If you put something heavy on that fabric, it will make an indentation in this fabric. This ball will travel on the indentation of the fabric that the heavier object creates. So, the moon stays not by some mysterious force, but because it rolls along the indentation created by the Earth. Einstein realized this. Gravity works like the fabric, warping space-time caused by the object within it. So gravity is the shape of space-time itself. In this way, space became not only real, but flexible. And so the difference between Einstein and Newton is that Newton saw space as passive and not moving, and Einstein saw it as dynamic, which means that space, he saw it as interwoven in time and dictating just how things move. For example, take a black hole. Now, black holes' gravity is so strong that it pulls everything toward it, it's quite the indentation, and twists it as it goes. It twists the fabric of space-time. The Earth twists space, just like in Einstein's theory. Well, to prove this one, we sent up Gravity Probe B, the product over almost half a century of research and ideas and everything. We sent up a gyroscope for this idea. This is basically a telescope that orbited Earth in a probe, and it focused on one star. This probe had four gyroscopes in it. The idea is that if the gyroscopes should always go around and always be pointed towards the same direction. Now, if this idea of twisting a fabric is right, then it should be just a little bit different when it comes back. It should, because the twist should actually twist these probes around too, if this is true. This was difficult to find because the difference is so minute. It's like trying to measure the diameter of a penny from 62 miles away. But in the end, they were able to get concrete data that, in fact, they do, just by Einstein's calculations, move. And this is the most real evidence we have to prove Einstein's theory of the fabric of space. So we know that the universe is expanding because the Big Bang at the very beginning was able to push everything out, and everything is still expanding today. Well, Einstein initially thought that, well, how could things must expand, but then gravity of everything will pull everything back. But in fact, we know from evidence now that that is not in fact true. That it is in fact, instead of decelerating as it should be to come back, it is accelerating. Now, that is, how could this be? It has a little bit to do with the properties of space itself on a quantum level. On a quantum level, space is very active and space is springy almost. This means that there is something on the quantum level of space that stretches gravity apart, and this is dark energy. Dark energy dominates the contents of the universe. It makes up 70% of the total weight of the universe. And the funny thing about dark energy is we really know nothing about it. That, for the level of the universe to not know about 70% of how the universe works, that's like not knowing about water. That's like not knowing anything about water, which is about 70% of Earth. And that's quite a lot. The point of that is that we are essentially clueless and really know nothing about it. So in the spaciousness of space, there is everything to it. On the very big level of the space fabric and the quantum level of the very weird ways that quantum works, and the activity in quantum level. But to conclude, that means that there is still a lot to discover about space, but I think it's very interesting to think that space is just so much we don't know about it, and the very mind-boggling part about it being a fabric, and the whole idea of space-time itself, which is part of what we are learning more about the universe today.